Paradise has its downsides after all.
I had a pizza last night without cheese. It was a very dire situation.
Because Adam's listening to sea shanties in the cockpit.
Maybe I gotta make an adjustment on my
end. No! Is there ever gonna be wind again? No. Goodbye, English Harbour.
Oh, I'm not even gonna need to winch that.
And we're underway again, this time up to Barbuda. Well, I can see that. We're about 5 miles away. A calm is meant to kind of start happening. Yeah, we'll do that.
In the summer of 2019, we had our first major setback in our plan. Our ill-fated attempt to cross the Atlantic.
What kind of a start to the journey is this?
In the summer of 2021, after a year of preparation, upgrades and repairs, we finally achieved our goal. On arrival, in addition to being blown away by the beauty of the Azores, we were left with the burning question.
Now that we're here, what the hell do we do?
With winter looming in the north, our visa clock squarely pointed at zero, and some minor repairs slated for the near future, we decided that the best plan would be to throw another 3,000 miles into the logbook and circle back to the Caribbean, where we would knock the jobs out of the park, circle back across the Atlantic with a fresh visa clock and pick up where we left off. Simple, right? Wrong. A series of COVID cases, one broken foot and a lost propeller shaft were among the multitude of reasons we did not make our scheduled departure and subsequently missed crossing season and were stuck once again in the Caribbean. Fast forward to 2023, crossing season is just about to begin and we're making steady progress north through the Lesser Antilles, visiting the few remaining islands we've yet to explore on our way to St. Martin, where we'll make our final preparations to cross the Atlantic with our sights set firmly on Norwegian fjords. Unfortunately, our steady progress has begun to slow. Having just arrived in Barbuda, the forecast window has served us up a prolonged calm. This, in conjunction with a squeaky water pump and 80 nautical miles to the nearest replacement, has left us whistling for the wind in paradise.
Very calm. We're sort of stuck here, to be honest. It's so calm for the next sort of 7 days. But hey, there's worse places to be stuck, right? There's like a reef on the sort of, which way would it be? The south western tip of the island. It's about a mile from here and then another mile offshore. We may not go that far, but in summary, we're going snorkeling.
Anchoring zone, so we just tied up to the ball that says please do not anchor, and there's a bunch of reef behind us, so we'll just go right in, I think.
Thank you.
great. Adam's like, go down and I'll film you. I was like, what? No. And then he went down. I was like, oh, they're all covered in sand. Like, that's amazing.
Okay. We went for a snorkel here, which was really, really lovely. I think we saw an eagle ray, which I've never actually seen before. That, for me, was like highlight of the whole dive. It was actually pretty good snorkeling here, which is really nice. So we've been here for a few days now, and the calm, as much as there is a wind blowing in the background, the forecast still says that it's meant to be like no wind, an absolute calm, which is so frustrating because we want to go like 80 miles more to the east to St. Martin because we've got some packages coming in and they are there already and we can't be there to pick them up because there's apparently not meant to be any wind here, even though our wind gen's going. And yeah, anyway, so we thought we might head on over to the main town called Codrington because we are pretty much out of all food. We have been off the grid since Green Island, so that's a good like a good few days now that we've been off the grid, and we're running out of like almost everything. I had a pizza last night without cheese. It was a very dire situation. It was just tomato bread, really. So we're gonna go down that way. I think we'll try and throw out a sail because why not? If there is wind, we'll definitely use it. Definitely enough to go downwind. So we'll try and do that. It's only 10 miles down there to Codrington. Turtle. Oh, he's a big one. This is really, really stressful being on watch because everything looks dark. Everything looks like something that we can hit. And initially the the charts as you're getting closer to shore actually don't really give you that much information, so you definitely need to eyeball it. You can't just rely on the charts. And there were some reef kind of right behind us that at low tide you could actually see the reef, like it was the rocks were actually visible. So I'm just and coming into the anchorage I didn't immediately see that, and that really scared me when I was like, oh wow, those are really close and they're visible, like above water it's definitely shallow here. So I'm just kind of looking around and just I'm a little stressed being up front and trying to spot all the bommies, but I think we're good. I think we're clear right now. It seems like just beautiful blue water from here. And we're getting into deeper water, thank God. Paradise has its downsides after all. Ah, oh, lovely day of sailing. This is really nice. What I can't love. A lovely 20 minutes so far of sailing. It's been so nice to have been there. We did spend a couple of days there, like snorkeling on a couple of days and just walking on the beach. It is a beautiful, beautiful spot, just where you can sit down, relax and just get off grid.
This is great. Lazy sailing at its finest. Just a head sail, downwind at very close on the wind. 6 knots apparent, doing 4.
That's almost my time.
I know, but the sails are full. We haven't got a main to worry about, so it's fine.
Do you think it's worth throwing a fishing rod out? Probably a bit slow. Oh yeah, it potentially might be a national park as well. Either way, we don't need fish, it's fine. All we need is flour and yeast and I can make fake pizzas. I'm up here in the peace and quiet of a bow because Adam's listening to sea shanties in the cockpit and they're really making me laugh. And we'll go back and join him in a second. Such a beautiful day though. It's really, really nice. Enjoying your sea shanty.
I didn't pick this song. I just got the whole album. I'm not responsible for what's on it.
This is making me laugh so
very
much.
Very strange.
I'm glad that we just managed to avoid that. That was pretty much hanging over Codrington just before we got here, so that was like really perfect timing. Ugh, it looks nasty.
So there's a sandbar that enters, that blocks the lagoon from the ocean side. It's just like a big shoal. And the reports say there's something in the middle of the low part that you can get through with the dinghy, and there's breakers elsewhere. So right now we're just crossing the sandbar. It seems to be breaking less here, and there is a bit of a stick there, which might be a marker. It also might just be a bit of driftwood. So we're just gonna slowly coast through here and hope that we don't touch bottom and get bowled over by a wave.
It looks quite deep there too.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that better.
I would say this one's better than here. I'm sure
still
we'd be fine.
Waist high water.
Yeah. Alright, so there's a rock or something right
paddle
there.
Paddle in.
Holy moly. Wow. Alright, there's rocks there. Can you see them?
Yeah,
go, go, go!
We use the wave in high water. There we go.
That's a good idea.
There you go, you just tack on the back of the wave and park on the back and use it to lift you over. It'd be fun going the other way.
Yeah.
Right,
so where's town
over there?
From all reports, it's a bit of a wet ride the other way.
So really we're on a quest for an ATM.
We have a minor issue. Come to shore, and I guess I expect this place to be a little more developed like Antigua is, and it's not. And when we came in here, we had to pay 10 EC to get to shore. There is like a dockage
just
fee
to
bring your dinghy
boat.
And so this is all that we have left to get food with. So till we find an ATM, of which I don't know if there is one. We have about 6 EC, which is the equivalent of about $2 to get some more food. I think there might be quite a few more canned goods in our future, unless we can find an ATM. Hello. Oh, come here, be friends. Come back. Baby.
We did need food, we can't find an ATM. Oh, we can sell it for some goat.
Oh, hello.
What's
he's found food.
Yeah, he's found food.
Oh my god, they're all there.
Lamb cutlets.
Oh no. Now to go back through the other side. Hope that we found the right place. Oh, well, we managed to find a ATM and then find a shop, which is good. So we do have some food, yay! Very basic provisioning, but yeah, it's better than nothing at least. All I can say is that I am glad to be back out in the vibrant waters.
As soon as we walk, sorry.
I don't think so. I'm having a conversation
with
him.
Me.
I think it's it looked a little bit like a war zone in there, and they definitely have not recovered from Irma. That was in late 2017. Don't know why I can speculate as much as the next person, but it's nice to be out in the vibrancy out here rather than seeing it's a little bit sad in there. All right, today we've made the decision to head off. We're gonna head off up to St. Martin. It's probably gonna be about an 80-mile sail. And I say, kind of say sail pretty loosely because this calm is now stretched on for about 10 days, which is a little bit ridiculous when we're meant to be in the trade winds. And right now we're getting about 7 knots. So although it might be breezy into the microphone, it's not actually that breezy. But we'll still try and sail. Something has to, like, this is better than the nothing that we've been seeing. So we're just going to try and go as is, really. What more can we do other than wait around here for another few more weeks?
I want to let the lazy jacks go this time.
Oh,
because they get stuck. It always, the spreaders always get, the battens always get stuck on the lazy jacks. So if I lower them and just pin them down while I do this, it might be a little bit easier.
Is that good?
Yep.
Oh, I just saw 8.9 knots. Woohoo! Angle, and we're doing, we've got about eight to nine knots of wind, which is not much at all, but we are kind of doing 5 knots. Could be doing more though if we put a spinnaker up, so we're gonna try doing that today.
Alright, stop there. Alright, start taking up some slack on the sheet. Cheers. So, as you can see, that's happening. It's hitting the solar panel strut. So you want the sheets for the kite as far back as you can, which is what we're trying to do here. But it's hitting the solar panel strut. So I'm happy to snub it once more. Just move it adjacent to that stanchion base key.
Make
an adjustment on my end.
No!
I thought the angle would be okay to be inside the pulpit.
Can you just tighten up a bit?
But I think outside the pulpit might be better.
All right. Is it going to rub on the anchor?
Yeah, well, it's pushing the pulpit forward.
Yep.
Why don't you have a go this time?
So the sun's starting to go down. We've been out here for about 6 hours now, I think.
5 days.
It's just a fist day. We've done slightly better than 7 miles, but certainly less than we expected. Considering we've got, like, I'm currently looking now, downwind we've got about 5 to 6 knots, which means that the actual wind speed is like 8 knots or something. So that's the true. Anyway, so it's been a slow going, but the spinnaker's still up, still been holding us. Occasional flapping, even from the spinnaker, which shows that, like, there is barely any wind out here. But at this stage, something's better than nothing. We need to get ourselves out, as mentioned, like, at least we're underway, you know?
Yeah, we're doing 4.5 knots.
It was just getting a bit ridiculous for us, like...
Just kept extending,
are we ever
too.
Is there ever gonna be wind again?
No.
Anyway, so some sailing is better than no sailing, and I'm not going to whinge at that.
It's good to occasionally flex your light wind sailing muscles. Yeah. You know? Like, you spend a lot of time waiting for, like, the wind, and you forget that you can
actually
go out
sail
in eight knots. Not fast, but you can go out there.
And it has actually been quite nice having, like, a flat boat, just going downstairs and making a cup of tea, and it's like, don't need to brace myself to anything right now. This is refreshing. Anyway, we're just going to start to make some dinner and settle in for the night, really. At this stage, I reckon we're going to keep the spinnaker up all night, but what do you reckon?
It is a pretty big moon. It's up already. And so it should be a bright night. There's not been any squirrels all day.
Mm.
So, and we've snuffed it and brought it back. Like, I'm pretty confident we can get rid of it in a hurry. So I think we'll carry it. And if it's squalls, yep, we'll take it down preemptively. If the wind pipes up, well, we'll get rid of it. So yeah, we'll just, yes, we'll carry it. Carry it as long as we can.
That's the plan. Probably about, it's 5:30 in the morning, just arrived, just as the sun's coming up, which is really great timing. And we actually managed to sail the whole way. Obviously, apart from now, when we've just turned the engine on for like 10 minutes to get in. We had a spinnaker up the whole night. It was not a problem. And yeah, sailed throughout the whole night. I'm so impressed that we managed to sail the whole time when there was like, the forecast was just blue. So really, really happy with us. Very, very good. Time for some sleep now.